quit my job down at the car wash, left my mama a goodbye note. By sundown, I left Kingston with my guitar up under my coat. I hitchhiked all the way down to Memphis, got a room at the YMCA. For the next 3 weeks, I went a-haunting them nightclubs looking for a place to play. Well, I thought my picking would set them on fire, but nobody wanted to hire a guitar man. Well, I nearly about starved to death down in Memphis. I run out of money and luck, so I bummed me a ride down to Macon, Georgia, on an overloaded poultry truck. I thumbed on down to Panama City, started checking out some of them all-night bars, hoping I could make myself a dollar making music on my guitar. Got the same old story, them all-night peers. There ain't no room around here for a guitar man. But don't need a guitar man, son. So I slept in hobo jungles, bummed a thousand miles of track, till I found myself in Mobile, Alabama, at a club they called Big Jack's. A little four-piece band was jamming, so I took my guitar and I set in. I showed them what a band would sound like with a swinging little guitar man. Show 'em, son. Take a trip down to the ocean, find yourself down around Mobile, or make it on out to the club called Jackson. You've got a little time to kill. Just follow that crowd of people, you'll wind up out on his dance floor, digging the finest little five-piece group up and down the Gulf of Mexico. And guess who leading that five-piece band? Well, wouldn't you know, it's that swinging little guitar man. Yeah, hey.
Georgia on my mind. Yeah. Georgia, Georgia, the song of you, it comes soft and clear like moonlight through the pine, yeah. Other arms reach out for me, and other eyes smile tenderly, still in peaceful dreams I see the road leading back to you, yeah. Georgia, Georgia, all the whole night through, just an old sweet song. Got Georgia on my mind, yeah. Yeah.
6 foot 6, he stood on the ground, weighed 235 pounds. But I saw that giant of a man brought down to his knees by love. He was the kind of man that would gamble on love, look you in the eye and never back up. But I saw him crying like a little whippup because of love. Can't see it with your eyes, hold it in your hand, but like the wind it covers our land. Strong enough to rule the heart of any man, this thing called love. It can lift you up, it can let you down, take your world, turn it all around. Ever since time, nothing's ever been found stronger than love. Most men are like me, they struggle in doubt, they trouble their mind day in and day out. Too busy with living to worry about a word called love. But when I see a mother's tenderness as she holds her young close to her breast, then I thank God this world's been blessed with a word called love. Can't see it with your eyes, hold it in your hand, but like the wind it covers our land. Strong enough to rule the heart of any man, this thing called love. It can lift you up, it can let you down, take your world, turn it all around. Ever since time, nothing's ever been found stronger than love.
I'm gonna tell you a story that's all about this job I had one time as a town scout. I'd had a hard day at the office and the boss wasn't in town. The day this hairy-legged guitar picker just happened to come around. Well, he walks into my office with a great big grin. And folks, that's where my story really begins. He said, son, my name is Beauregard Rippy. Come to you from Tupelo, Mississippi. I write songs and I sing like a bird. I play licks on my guitar like you ain't never heard. But I'm down on my luck, things are just a little slack. I got a quarter in my pocket and a shirt on my back. But you buy me some supper, give me a place I can sleep. Said I'll sing you some songs and knock your head in the creek. I got talent, boy. Sit back home, they call me the Tupelo, Mississippi Flash. Well, I knew I was in a room with some kind of a nut when he pulled out that pack of used cigarette butts. So that's when I told him, we can't use you today. So I handed the boy a dollar and I sent him on his way. Well, the boss got back and we both had a laugh when I told him about the Tupelo, Mississippi Flash. And pretty soon I had the story circulating around about this Mississippi nut that we had in our town. I said, watch him, everybody, the boy's squirreling. He walks around, calls himself the Tupelo, Mississippi Flash. Well, then it happened one day while I was driving to my home. I just happened to have my car radio on when I heard a jockey raving about a brand new smash by a kid called the Tupelo, Mississippi Flash. Well, I almost wrecked my automobile. I went through red lights. I hit a traffic cop. Why? Well, my story's got an ending and it's short and sweet. The boss man, he fired me and left me out in the street. But I got a new job now and I'm learning real fast. I'm driving the bus for the Tupelo, Mississippi Flash. And his Cadillac, I'm driving that farm too. And that yacht he's got. And his airplane. Well, chauffeur, sure good, I always say. That's a Tupelo, Mississippi. Who ever heard of it? Why, I'll kill the boy. Help him, somebody.
Yes, here comes Amos.
Now Amos Moses was a Cajun. He lived by himself in the swamp. He hunted alligator for a living. He just knock him in the head with a stump. The Louisiana law gon' get you, Amos. It ain't legal hunting alligator down in the swamp, boy. Now everybody blamed his old man for making him mean as a snake. When Amos Moses was a boy, his daddy would use him for alligator bait. Tie a rope around his waist and throw him in the swamp. Alligator bait in the Louisiana Bayou. About 45 minutes southeast of Tippido, Louisiana, lived a man called Doc Millsap and his pretty wife and all. Well, they raised up a son that could eat up his bait and groceries. Named him after a man of the cloth. Call him Amos Moses.
Yeah.
Now all the folks around South Louisiana said Amos was a hell of a man. He could trap the biggest, the meanest alligator and just use one hand. That's all he got left called alligator bitty. Left arm gone clean up to the elbow. Well, the sheriff got wind and Amos was in the swamp trapping alligator skin. So he snuck in the swamp gonna get the boy, but he never come out again. Well, I wonder where the Louisiana sheriff went to. Well, you can so get lost in the Louisiana Bayou. About 45 minutes southeast of Tippido, Louisiana, lived a cat called Doc Millsap and his pretty wife Hannah. Well, they raised up a son that could eat up his weight in groceries. Named him after a man of the cloth. Called him Amos Moses. Sit down on him, Amos. Make it count, son. About 45 minutes southeast to Tippido, Louisiana. Lived a man called Doc Millsap and his pretty wife.
When the sun came up this morning, I took the time to watch it rise. And as its beauty struck the darkness from the skies, I thought how small and unimportant all my troubles seemed to be, and how lucky another day belongs to me. And as the sleepy world around me woke up to greet the day, all its silent beauty seemed to say, so what, my friend, if all your dreams you haven't realized, look around you, boy, you've got a whole new day to try. Today is mine, today is mine, to do with what I will. Today is mine, my own special cup to fill. Die a little that I might learn to live, to take from life that I might learn to give. Today is mine. Like all men, I curse the present that seems void of peace of mind, and race my thoughts beyond tomorrow and vision there more peace of mind. But when I view the day around me, I can see the fool I've been, for today is the only garden we can tend. Today is mine, today is mine, to do with what I will. Today is mine, my own special cup to fill. To die a little, that I might learn to live. To take from life, that I might learn to give. Today is mine.
Thank you. Still talk about it today. How the down broke loose on Eddie Ball nearly washing everybody away. Fun the river water ride, washing up all the bushes. Well, the headline said how mother said my son would have lost his life, but he was pulled from the mud in the Edamore River by the man y'all all despise. Look old Joe, they called him the Edamore River swamp rat, and folks despised him.
Look old Joe,
look old Joe. So be careful what you say, my friend, about folks you don't understand. Someday you might need a man like Cook Old Joe. Go ahead on, son.
Cook Old Joe.
Cook Old Joe. They called him the Edamore River swamp rat, and folks despised him.
Now I'm a U.S. male, because I was born in a South Georgia town on a Sunday morning. Now, Georgia just happens to occupy a place in the southeastern portion of these United States. Now, that's a fact, buddy, and you know it well. So I just call myself the U.S. Male. M-A-L-E, son, that's me. Now, said all that to say all this. I've been a-watching the way you've been a-watching my miss. For the past 3 weeks, you've been hot on the trail. You kind of upsetting the U.S. Male. Now you touch her once with your greasy hand, I'm gonna stretch your neck like a long rubber band. Cause she's wearing a ring that I bought on sale, so that makes her the property of this U.S. mail. So you better not mess with the U.S. mail, my friend. If the U.S. mail gets mad, it's gonna do you in. If you know what's good for yourself, son, you go find you somebody else, son. Don't tamper with the property of the U.S. mail. The U.S. mail is on his toe. So quit watching my woman, cause that ain't wise. You ain't pulling no wool over this boy's eye. Now I catch you around my woman, champ, I'm gonna leave your head about the shape of a stamp. Kinda flattened out, so you do well to quit playing games with the U.S. mail. So you better not mess with the U.S. mail, my friend. If the U.S. mail gets mad, it gonna do you in. If you know what's good for yourself, son, you go find you somebody else, son. Don't tamper with the property of the U.S. mail. Tell him you talk. Yeah. Yeah. Now I'm telling you, son,